Hey, guys, there is someone I want you to meet. Pam, this is my family. Family, this is my girlfriend, Pam.
You know, Chris, Usher categorizes his girls into two groups. Bitches he's with and bitches he's gonna get with. So is this one you got or one you gonna get?
Wait, Jerome's daughter is your girlfriend? Chris, can I speak to you for a moment, privately?
I voted for Obama once.
Dad, if this is about Pam...
Yes, it is about Pam. And I have something to say. Chris, she's not fat.
What?
I figured the day you came home with a girl, we'd have to back her through the garage. A little further, a little further, a little further. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, all right. Now, do you prefer Fatty or Miss Boombaladdy?
So you don't mind that Pam is black?
Chris, it's 1998.
Actually, Daddy.
Peter Griffin does not see color. Now, let's go see if your mom's done listing all the black people she's ever seen on television.
Flip Wilson, John Amos, Diane Carroll, that monster that plays tennis.
So I saw Chris is dating Jerome's daughter. Looks like they've had some pretty hot dates.
Don't look at my kids when they're off doing their private lives. Hey, there's my new brother-in-law brother now.
Griffin, you and me have to talk.
What's up, blood?
Nobody's dating nobody. You understand?
Oh, don't worry, Jerome. I already gave Chris the sex talk. It's awesome.
Peter, you don't understand. I don't want Pam dating a white boy.
What? Jerome, you're a racist.
Black people can't be racist. We can be way sexist, but we ain't racist.
Sure, black people can be racist. They gave Michelle Pfeiffer such a hard time. She didn't pick that school. They sent her there.
Coolio had her back.
Look, I think if you got to know us better, you wouldn't have any problem with your daughter dating one of us.
I'll date her.
Look, why don't you and Pam come over tomorrow night, and you'll see that white people are even better than black people.
Peter.
You know what I mean. They're equal. Separate, but equal.
Peter?
Just equal.
All right, we'll come to dinner. But I want you to know I'm very skeptical about this whole thing.
Oh, that's okay. Hey, listen, I was skeptical about traveling to Mexico. I took one step outside the resort.
Thanks for having us to dinner, Mrs. Griffin.
Oh, my pleasure, Pam.
Yes, I, for one, say this is long overdue. It's about time people of color broke bread at this table.
Broke bread? Who are you, St. Francis of Assisi all of a sudden?
Jerome, you have done a wonderful job raising Pam to be a lovely young woman.
You say that like you're surprised.
I beg your pardon?
Sounds like you're saying a single black man can't raise a child on his own.
Yes, Lois, what are you saying? You know, before I speak, I like to ask myself, would Dr. King approve of what I'm about to say? Most of the time, I find that he would.
Dad, I think Mrs. Griffin was just giving you a compliment.
Yeah, I was just trying to say we all appreciate having you in our home.
Oh, so suddenly we're all friends.
We've always been friends.
If we're friends, what's my last name?
Cool J.
Where am I from?
The south part of a large city.
Where'd I go to college?
Does it air commercials during daytime judge programs?
Peter, you only got two of those three things right. Look, I know what this is about. You're being all nice just so your son can get into my daughter's pants.
Dad, stop it.
White guys don't want a relationship with black women. They just want a notch on their belt. You're a novelty to these people.
These people? This is the moment in the meal when I stand up.
Wait a minute. A novelty? We used to date before I met Peter. So what are white women to black men?
A very pleasant page in our memory books.
Aw.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You banged my wife.
She did? No wonder I had so much room in there. Her womb was like one of those places where they reconstruct crashed airplanes.